positive for the United States in that we are importing a heck of a lot less oil from the Middle East than we ever have before. So it's a good news, bad news, and we'll talk about some of those things. Oil production is not just the last few years of the last century. The Romans, a lot of the older civilizations, used oil for various activities. They didn't drill wells or frack horizontal wells. They just scooped the stuff up where it seeped out of the ground. And it would seep up fractures in the ground and bubble to the surface. There were even some of the deposits that had caught on fire from probably lightning strikes. You had people worshiping the fires, the Zoroasters over in the Middle East, and it was all oil. Here in the United States, Colonel Drake drilled a well in 1859 in an area that mysteriously was called Oil Creek. And Oil Creek was called that because that's where folks would go and scoop oil out of the creek. It was floating on the surface. It was not pollution due to a tanker disaster or a leaking pipeline. It was naturally seeping out of the ground. And he drilled the modern well there. It was pretty deep. It was 69 feet deep. And he was able to get about 20 or 30 barrels a day out of that. A barrel, by the way, I'll refer to barrels of oil. A petroleum barrel is 42 gallons. So that'll give you a little bit more of an idea. When I start talking about a billion barrels, that's 42 million gallons of fluid. But not too long after this, in about 1861, here in Colorado, down near Canyon City, around Florence, there was quite a bit of oil drilling because there were fractures there in the rock. And there's a place called Oil Creek again, not the same creek, but another oil creek. They called it Oil Creek because, doggone it, there's oil seeping out of the ground there. So they thought it would be a good place to look for oil, sort of like looking for acorns. You look for acorns underneath an oak tree. And by 1862, just 3 years after his first well, people were just going totally bonkers there. They were producing oil, flowing it into open-top barrels, and as you might imagine, some of those would catch on fire. They'd have a heck of a mess. In the 2000s, oil activity was not with big open tanks. It was not scattered all over the place. Environmental regulations were put in place. Bonding was put in place to force people to clean up and try to keep from having a huge mess out on the ground. After production is established, many of the pumping wells have a very small footprint, about the size of this room or smaller. And then you'll have flow lines going from this pump jack over to a central production facility. So you have a few scattered footprints of activity, and the rest of the area can be farmed or ranched or whatever. In about 1970, the United States hit a peak oil production rate of about 10 million barrels a day, and that would be, 420 million gallons a day. And then after that, production started trickling downward, and that was when we began